guys, good afternoon. I know you guys have seen some of my little videos, me showing me cooking on this 1860s wood burning cook stove. And I just wanted to bring you along today and show you what it really takes to make a really good meal on one of these stoves. And I'm gonna take you through all the way from start from scratch. I got the wood loaded in the fire, but I haven't lit it yet. I'm gonna show you how I've got it stacked in here. And I'm gonna pretty much show you step by step how to. I'm not gonna get real fancy with it. I'm gonna make fried chicken. Instant mashed potatoes and gravy. And I think I'll get a jar of green beans out and make them too. Alright, so you might as well say a can of green beans, some instant potatoes, and some from scratch fried chicken. I'm gonna do drumsticks. That's what they had on sale down at the store. But, I'm in a real prepper type situation now. I hurt my back during the summer. I was bedridden for 3 months, no pay. I can't work. I don't have money for food or rent or utilities or any of that good stuff. So I'm roughing it. And but my son, before all this took place, seen this stove, and he acquired this stove, and he brought it to me, and when all this is said and done, not a stage, but I want to build me place to film, an authentic place to film, and that way I can have all my cast iron and all my cookware and everything that it takes to put on a 1860s meal. Right now, look at my hands. My hands are all sooted up. I've been messing with the stove. It's a fact. You always need a pot of water on the stove. And the first week, I didn't let it go out. The first couple of weeks, I didn't let it go out. But it could become a firewood problem. I run out of good firewood. And now it's down. I'm down. And then you got to have a lot of pine knots, rich lighter pine, whatever you want to call it, fat pine. Some people call it wood, but I'll show you. This is a pine knot right here. This is a pine knot. I'm gonna put this in there whole because I'm gonna be frying. I got my wood stacked up down in here. Let me get you over here where you can see. Okay, as you can see, I got some paper down in the bottom down there. I got a bed of ashes that helps it, that always helps it burn a little bit better. In my book. Now I got a couple pieces of some good oak in here. Okay. Some paper down in there. And I got my rich lighter pine. I got it split up to where I can reach in there and put it in there on top of my paper. And I'm gonna light that paper and I'm gonna get it on there and get it going. And then I'm gonna take and set this pine knot right here. Right in down there on top of there, and then I'm gonna put my stove grates on, and I'm gonna get this puppy going, get my water going so we can have some hot water and get the grease warming up, because this is a real fried chicken is a real slow cooking process. And there goes my buddy on his motor scooter. I really want me one of those. Gas it! fired up. He's a pretty cool dude. I'm gonna use one of these little thick lines, but y'all's benefit today. You can do it the old Boy Scout way. Diamond strike anywhere match. Let's see if we can do this. Way. Look at here what I got going on. Lay that right in there like that. Okay. So I gotta wash my hands anyway. I'm gonna go ahead and handle these crates by hand. I gotta wash my hands terribly. Old pine soot gets on everything. Undo me and everything. So this is the process you go through right here. Alright, I'm gonna leave this one right here open until it gets to rolling. Okay, we've got the bottom down here open. We got our dampener all the way open here. We got our dampener all the way open there. Okay. Now this is not a 1860, this is a wire brush. And what we're gonna do with this, we're gonna take, let's go ahead and just kind of put this in place. And at this point right here, it's just kind of smoky. I need to get me a pipe going out there. Just gonna clean the stove. It's an initial clean. This thing has been sitting outside for ages whenever my son got it. And I just been kind of working with it. And I have not got any stove black yet. I'm gonna get some stove black. I'll do a video on how to stove black it. But I just cleaned it up and started using it. I need some way to cook me something for the day and how to smoke it out and started using it. And it's got things on it. It needs to be done. No doubt about it. You're gonna leave me some nasty comments down below, it'll be alright. I don't care. Say whatever you want to say. I didn't live in 1860s. I don't know how to do this. I'm not a professional. I'm telling you how I'm gonna do it. And I'm gonna treat this top right here just like I would one of my cast iron skillets. Now let's get this off of here. That way it can breathe. We can get some real good rolling fire going. Small pot of water here. Get up here that way. We'll get our hands washed. Let's just go ahead and get that heated up. Right there. Find my skillet. Fire going on in here, it's starting to heat up. It won't take long, we'll have boiling water. I'll get me a little pot, give me some water to boil for my potatoes. I'll get a little pot for my green beans. I want to get my hands clean first. I don't walk in my house in this pine soot on me. My house. You tell I got flames coming out here now. So it's heating this whole thing up. In order to fry anything or cook anything in the oven, you have got to have a hot fire. So some good pine is very, very, very critical. This is not smoking. This is not smoking, but even though it's emitting a lot of smoke, there should be a pipe coming out of here. This should be pretty much smokeless down here. Okay, so our chicken is all cleaned up, thawed out, and now we're fixing to make a mess. The first thing we'll do is get this here mustard. We're going to pretend like we're in 1860s Louisiana. We're going to have some coon-ass fried chicken. We got some of this here scorpion stinger sauce. It's homemade. Put that in there. We ain't going to touch our hands to our face until we're done with this. Okay? Now, we're going to take Tony's Ketchery. Put that in there real liberally in there. I do it in the oven. And I want to do it on top of the stove because this stove cooks a lot slower than what you're accustomed to. Now I've got this incorporated real well on here. Now I need to wash my hands. I need to get some flour and get this
taken care of.
Looks like we're going to be interrupted. smell what I got going on with it. Hey, baby. I really like your Jeep Renegade. Thank you. Thank you. Oh my God.
There's no restaurant. Oh, there ain't no kitchen nowhere that can touch this chicken right here. Nowhere. Nowhere. That